Now, when we left, you were about to say...
Yeah, what was I going to say? Let me tell you, the fellow who was the editor for Putnam's, who bought this book. See, it was a bestseller in Britain, and then they buy it. And he said, I'm told this fellow has bought the book. So he's on the phone, and he says, oh, Mr. Granger, I just love your book. I said, I'm mad about your book. He said, but I don't like the title. Sparks fly up, but he said, I got a better title. I said, yeah. Confessions, he said. Confessions? He said, and I'm not mad about the beginning of the book, because he said, I think it should start, you know, when you're a star. You know, people want to read about when you're a star. This stuff about the war and you're a kid. And he said, the ending, I'm not mad about... I said, you love the book, you want to change the title, you want to change the beginning, you want to change the end, get stuck, you know, and then I'm afraid he got
the book's already
rather upset. It's a bestseller in Britain. He's rather upset, anyway, I didn't come on here to talk about the book.
No, I want to know, please, what does Sparks Fly Upward mean?
Don't you know that?
No.
You don't read the Bible?
My goodness.
Man is born unto trouble as the sparks fly upward. And this is a book about trouble, I'll tell you. Book of Job. Yeah. We read it every night, Mike.
Just before bed.
You read it every night.
No, I don't.
I'm happy to read. I have to read this before I go to bed, you see. You've been interviewed dozens of times in the past few days concerning
about Grace.
Princess Grace.
Wasn't that terrible?
It's so difficult when people call and ask you for a comment.
It's so dreadful because I was with her 3 months ago. I mean, I made a film with her. I was very close to her years ago. And I had seen her a few times, but 3 months ago, we did this show in Philadelphia where her leading men came up, you know, Jimmy Stewart and Frank Sinatra. Yeah. And I'm afraid they're mostly dead. And we went that, you know, we were almost. And we, and she looked lovely, you know. She was 52, lovely. She looked gorgeous. And I said, I fancied you 30 years ago, and I fancy you now. You know, you look absolutely lovely. When are you going to come back? And she said, do you know, I really would like to. I'd like this. She was getting, I think she was fed up with that scene in Monte Carlo.
I wonder about that. I was talking to Julie Harris. I don't mean to name drop that way, but I was talking about a woman who came from what she had come from and done what she had done in those brilliant films in that small amount, 11 films in 5 years. And then to that sort of fairy tale existence and
pressure,
and,
but it was
and
heavy.
fulfilling, I'm sure, and heavy and pressure. And
yeah, it was heavy.
But this got to be because she said that wonderful quote, I was on my way to becoming an actress.
Yeah,
and there's that still in that woman was.
Well, she was a darling woman. I loved her dearly. I thought she was a sweet, sweet woman. And I got the impression that she found it all a bit heavy over there.
But do you feel it's right for the press to immediately congregate on Friends after a tragedy?
No, awful. It was the only reason they used me was because they couldn't get Frank Sinatra or Ray Milland or Cary Grant, so they got
that
on me.
But
I don't know. They were too intelligent. I think they probably said, I'm not available or something. I just said, oh, well, fellas, all right. Because I wanted to say something about it. I didn't know it would be that mad, because I was on, I think it was 7 shows in my house.
The reason I agree with you that she might have come back is because when I interviewed her, when I was told, for heaven's sakes, don't talk about her movies, and I just casually, when I felt she was ready, I said, do you watch yourself on The Late Show?
Mm.
And she changed, her personality almost changed. Mm. For a moment, she wasn't the princess when I said that.
Mm. Can I tell you something about the Kelly family? Do you know about the Kelly family?
Yeah.
All right. Kelly was a bricklayer. Right? And he came to England. He made some money. He came to England. I used to be a sculler, right? I rode for the London Rowing Club. And sculling, the peak is the diamond skulls, right? At Henley, very pompous in those days. And Kelly came over and he won the diamond skulls. And they refused to give it to him because they said he was a professional. He used his hands. He was a bricklayer. So they wouldn't give it to him. So Kelly goes back, becomes a millionaire, has this wonderful son, trains him, and the son goes over and wins the diamond skull.
That's right.
Now that is a fairy story
that's
itself, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, that's very.
And then he also happens to have a rather nice-looking daughter called Grace, who comes to Hollywood and wins, you know,
Academy Award.
Her own Academy Award.
Yeah. And when I went to the show, I remember everybody was in tails at this show in Philadelphia. And Bob Hope is doing the tails. And I had a dinner jacket. I didn't have my tails with me. I hadn't brought them from England. So I go on, and I say, I really shouldn't be here, because Grace Kelly made very few films, and most of them very distinguished, and she only made one real dog, and that was with me, and that's why I'm wearing a black tie. So I got a big laugh, and she came over afterwards. She was sweet, and she said, "Jimmy, you know, it wasn't a bad film."
She called you Jimmy.
Oh, you mean she called me Jimmy? I was with her for 4 months.
No, but you're Stuart Granger to us.
Oh, Jimmy, my name is Jimmy. You call
His
me
real
Jimmy.
Name is
my
Jimmy Stewart,
yeah,
ladies and gentlemen.
You call me Jimmy.
Jimmy
is up. So she was adorable, and I'm very sad. And did you see the picture of laid out?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah.
I thought that was
a macabre sort of thing. It's a little frightening to feel that as soon as a great person dies, immediately the next day, they have all the obituaries, big, long columns.
How have they been composing?
Every one of us that has any prominence at all, our obituary is sitting there waiting for somebody to go over and pull it out. Isn't that something?
Do you think anybody will care about us like they care about Grace?
Yes, to sell papers.
No, we will get maybe a couple of lines.
We're keeping all these wonderful people. We're coming right back. Don't leave.
Oh, don't leave. How much longer do we have? I haven't mentioned.